Krishna.
Where's Amy?
Amy. Maharaj.
Oh, you're in that bed,
now.
I'm hearing your voice.
You're
not speaking.
Thank you.
Okay, Om Gyana Timirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shiva Sadigor Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing about Gop Kumar, and at this point the pastimes of Lord Krishna are being told to Gop Kumar. And we're hearing about how Akrura came to Vrindavan and he took Krishna away to bring him to Mathura. So of course it was very painful for the gopis. The gopis did not want Krishna to leave them. However, finally, he managed to get Krishna and Balaram onto his chariot, and then he drove the chariot very swiftly. The horses which were pulling the chariot, they were well trained, but they were followers of Kamsa. Kamsa had sent Akrura to go and bring Krishna to Mathura. So Akrura is driving the chariot and it's going so fast, nobody can tell where he went. It would just go so fast, it disappears. So the cowherd men, like Nanda Maharaj, they also were going to go to Mathura. They wanted to also go with Krishna to Mathura. So they were coming on their own carts. They have their own carts pulled by big bulls. The gopis, they didn't get to go, only the cowherd men were going.
成行，只有那些牧牛郎才能有机会去。
So Akrura brought Lord Krishna to Lord Brahma's lake. It's on the road to Mathura.
Akrura 就把 Krishna 带到了主 Brahma 的湖。这个湖呢是坐落在这个路边上。
And at that place, Akrura offered many prayers to Lord Krishna.
就在这个湖中 ，Akrura 就向主 Krishna 供奉了许许多多的祷文。
That place where the Lake of Brahma is also known as Akrura Tirtha.
这个
previously and after contact with Krishna consciousness and the holy name, and she became very she liked the.Bhagavad Gita very much and began to regularly chant and read. Her question, she had three questions. The first one is how to get rid of the ideas in her mind that to distinguish between Krishna consciousness and Buddhism and to make herselfconcentrate on Krishna, on the progress of Krishna consciousness very quickly.
Yes, she should concentrate on hearing and chanting. And that if she hears and chants about Krishna, then if she fills her mind with thoughts of topics of Krishna, then she'll forget about Buddha.
她应该专注于聆听和唱诵，她应该让她的就是心意充满有关于 Krishna 的话题，这样呢，他就会忘记那个有关于佛陀。
Yeah, sometimes people have difficulty like that. They remember the things they were doing before they come to Krishna consciousness. So you have to work on hearing and chanting about Krishna.
有时候呢，人们确实是有这种困难，他们总是能想起他们在。进入 Krishna 知觉之前的那些的知识，所以他们这时候要下的功夫就是聆听和唱诵有关于 Krishna。
And gradually, you can leave behind the Buddha and just concentrate on Krishna.
这样渐渐的、逐渐的、一步一步的，就能忘记 Buddha 佛陀，然后就能一心一意的想着 Krishna。
You have to be patient because you spent some time in Buddhism, so you have to concentrate now on hearing about Krishna.
需要有耐心，这需要花一些时间，需要特别的专心的聆听有关于 Krishna.
Because she passed so many years in Buddhism, so it will take some time to get over the Buddhism.
因为他长年累月的呢，都是沉浸在佛教当中，所以要想跨越，要想克服跨越这一阶段呢，是需要花一段日子的。
嗯 ，What's the 第二个问题？
第二个问题，如果还没有，如果他没见过，但是愿意得到咕噜的保护和仁慈，是否也可以在家里供奉咕噜的照片呢？She's willing to get protection and mercy from Guru. Can she also have the picture of Guru in her heart, in her home?
Yes, you should begin with Prabhupada's picture. First of all, everybody who comes to Krishna consciousness, first thing you have to do is take shelter of Srila Prabhupada.
可以的，但是呢，就是也要有Srila Prabhupada的照片，在就任何人，他们第一件事呢，加入 Krishna 之前，都是首先要托庇于Srila Prabhupada。
Srila Prabhupada is the Shiksha Guru, is an instructing spiritual master for all the members in the movement.
Srila Prabhupada 是这个运动当中所有成员的 Shiksha Guru， 所有成员的训士 Guru。
So you should have Srila Prabhupada's picture there。
所以你应该在你的那个供坛上有 Srila Prabhupada 的照片。
And you should think, first of all, you should think Srila Prabhupada is your Guru。
首先你应该想着 Srila Prabhupada 是你的训士 Guru。
And later on, you can also take a Diksha Guru。
然后在此之后你可以接受一位启迪 Guru， Diksha Guru。
But first thing, you get attached to Prabhupada。
第一件事就是首先要变得依附于 Srila Prabhupada。
Okay, yes, dear, 第三个问题。
第三个问题是最后一个问题就是有些新人加入，因为不了解他们，就把联谊活动放在户外，好处是更容易传播圣名，缺点是没有神像崇拜，请问姑对此有何建议？ Because some, recently there are some new fighters joining,Because we are not familiar with them, therefore we arrange this association outdoors. The benefit is that it's easy to spread the holy name, but the defect is that there are no deities. So Guru, do you have any advice on this point?
Well, just chanting the holy name is very good. You don't need deities. Deities are not so necessary.
只要唱诵圣名就好了，就足够了，不需要神像。神像是不是必要的。
In the beginning, start off with the chanting of the holy name and get people, let people develop an attachment and a taste for the chanting of the holy name.
一开始就让人们就发展出对于圣名的品味，对圣名的依附。
In the Kali Yuga, in this age, the process is chanting the holy name.
在 Kali Yuga, 在这个年代的大法门是唱诵圣名。
And Krishna,is the holy name. There's no difference between the holy name and Lord Krishna himself.
Krishna 就是圣名，主 Krishna 和圣名 Krishna 没有区别。
So don't be too eager to bring deities. That can come later. The main thing is to get people attached to the chanting of the holy name and gradually teach them the philosophy.
所以不要急着要渴望有神像，这个是后来的事情。那首先呢是要让人们依附于圣名。
And the philosophy.
而且让人们变得依附于这门哲学。
So you have to, they have to hear gradually. They have to hear the philosophy and learn.Develop a taste for the holy name and also prasadam, very important.
So, you should gradually let people listen to this philosophy and let people know the holy name. And there is also an important element, which is prasadam.
So, the chanting of the holy name and prasadam are very powerful and they will help people to become very.Steady and strong in Krishna consciousness.
圣名还有 prasadam 这两个要素是非常有力量的，可以让人们逐渐的就变得稳定，变得在 Krishna 之觉变得很坚定。下一个问题是来自 Panchatattva Prabhu 顶拜 Maharaj。顶拜所有奉献者 ，Krishna 永远不离开 Vrindavan。Nanda Maharaj 不知道这一点吗？还是 Krishna 不让他知道呢？ obeisance, Maharaj, obeisance to all devotees. Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. Doesn't Nanda Maharaj know this? Or that Krishna doesn't want Nanda Maharaj to know this?
Well, certainly in the pastime, Krishna is leaving Vrindavan. He's going to Mathura, and Nanda Maharaj also went with him to Mathura. And so you say Krishna never leaves Vrindavan, but that's Krishna in his unmanifest form, never leaves Vrindavan.
Krishna离开了马图拉，南达玛拉这也一起去了马图拉。就你说到Krishna从来不离开文达文的，这个位Krishna是那个从不展示的，从不展示的Krishna的形象，那个形象是从来不离开文达文的。Yeah,
Krishna hid himself in the hearts of all the gopis. But Nanda Maharaj has a relationship with the manifest form of Krishna. He doesn't just want Krishna in his heart. He doesn't just want Krishna unmanifest, he wants Krishna personally manifest there with him. So Nanda Maharaj, he feels, you know, it's a special lila. Krishna leaving Vrindavan is a lila which awakens more affection, more love for Krishna. It awakens the feeling, the attachment for Krishna more. So Krishna, and he also wants to give the devotees more and more ecstasy. He wants them to experience this loving ecstasy. And when he goes away from them, then they become more attached to him, they're more anxious for him, and then they appreciate more when he comes back to them. Yeah, the pain, the crying which they're doing, this is spiritual ecstasy.
Yuna, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj and devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Question about Brahma Vimohana Lila. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it said that Brahma took away the fake cowherd boys and cows, and Krishna spent his milk himself in their expansions. Where did the real cowherd boys go in that case? 这个问题来自于呢，请拜Guru Maharaj的奉献者们，荣耀归于Srila Prabhupada。这个问题是有关于 Brahma Brahma 被 Mohana， Brahma 被迷惑的消失光。圣典博加瓦坛说 ，Brahma 带走的是那些假的木牛童和牛犊 ，Krishna 呢把他自己扩展了他自身。但那些真的木牛童去了哪里呢？谢谢。
Brahma took them away and hid them.
Brahma 拿走了，然后把他们藏了起来。
No, he hid them.
Brahma 把他们藏了起来。
He had them put them in a cave somewhere.
把他们都藏在了一个山洞里。
Brahma is also very powerful. He could do these things.
Brahma 他可是强有力的人物，这一点他是能做到的。
So he took them away from Krishna.
所以主 Brahma 把这些木牛童和牛犊都从 Krishna 身边给拿走了。
Okay.
下一个问题，华为五，什么是规范的修习 ？What is sadhana bhakti?
Sadhana bhakti.Sadhana Bhakti is to follow the four regulative principles and to chant Hare Krishna regularly and to read the scriptures like Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam.
规范修习是遵守四项原则，唱诵 Hare Krishna， 有规律的阅读经典，博加梵歌，圣典博加瓦坛。
Wake up early in the morning and.Worship Krishna. Well, after taking bath and putting tilak on the body, then you have to chant Hare Krishna. Then cook food and offer it to Krishna.
做饭，然后把这些食物供奉给 Krishna。
So this is sadhana bhakti。
所以这就是规范的修习 ，sadhana bhakti。
You should have a regulated program, pretty much the same every morning。
应该有一个规律的活动，基本上每天早上是一样的。
And if you do good sadhana bhakti, then your mind will become Krishna conscious.
如果你的规范修习做得非常好的话，那你的心意呢，就是很有 Krishna 知觉了。
You will forget about sense gratification.
你就会忘记感官享乐。
下一个问题。
下一个 Chaitanya Charam Prabhu.Hare Krishna, 明白 Gurudev。Vrindavan 离 Mathura 那么近， Vrindavan 居民离不开 Krishna。他可以去 Mathura 见 Krishna， 为什么不去 Mathura 见 Krishna， 而在 Vrindavan 痛苦呢？ Hare Krishna, basis Gurudev。Vrindavan is not far from Mathura. Why the residents of Vrindavan don't leave?Vrindavan and go to Mathura to see Krishna. Why they are suffering in Vrindavan?
Well, you have to understand, they go by bullock cart, so it's not so fast to go to Vrindavan, from Vrindavan to Mathura. You take a bus or you take a motor vehicle, but they're going by bullock cart, so it takes some time.And they have many duties. The people of Vrindavan, they have many cows to take care of. And they have their children, they have many things to do in Vrindavan. They cannot just go on, whenever they want, go to Mathura.
坐上了那个车或者坐着交通工具就去了 Mathura， 所以而且他们在马托热呢，他们在文达文，他们有很多的职责，他们要照料母牛，照料孩子，他们有很多事情要做，不是说什么时候他们想走就可以拔脚就走的。
We have to understand also Kamsa was there in Mathura, and the people are afraid of Kamsa. They don't want to get too close to Kamsa. If they go to Mathura, they may get problems from Kamsa or Kamsa's people, Kamsa's servants.
别忘了，在马托热还有 Kamsa 国王呢。然后，人们都害怕康瑟吧，不想离他太近。如果他们去马托热的话，那他们康瑟以及康瑟的那些走狗、党羽、仆人们就会给他们找麻烦。
嗯。OK， 下一个问题。
Shyamala Tha Devadasi Hare Krishna， 明白 Gurudev 的莲花组。感恩 Gurudev 的仁慈，在《薄伽梵歌》中第18章气绝的完美境界中说道，人离开躯体时要想着 Krishna 的原始形体，那么 Krishna 的原始形体是在给 Arjuna 讲述薄伽梵歌的形体。我想知道，是 Krishna 显示宇宙的形体吗？Lord Krishna, obeisance goes to lotus feet of Gurudev. Thank you for your mercy. In the 18th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, the perfection of renunciation is said that when one leaves his body, one has to think about the original form of Krishna. Then the original form of Krishna is...the form that is speaking Bhagavad Gita. So I want to know, is it the form that Krishna the universal form that Krishna manifested?
No. The universal form, that's a temporary form, that's a material form.No, let me hear that question again, Guru Mani. Can you answer it again?
So this devotee, she said that she mistook the original form of Krishna as whether the form that is Krishna relating Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna, or she mistook the original form to be the universal form.So she doesn't know what she mistook the original form to be the Krishna speaking Bhagavad Gita, and she's not sure whether the original form is the universal form.
No, the universal form is not the original form.
Krishna 的宇宙形体不是他的原始形体。
That's a temporary material form.It's a manifestation, temporary manifestation. But Krishna showed Arjuna the forearm form, and Arjuna also was not satisfied when he saw the forearm form, and he asked Krishna to show his original form, which is the two-arm form.
Krishna 就像Krishna 展示出了向尔中的展示了四臂形体，尔中的见到之后呢，内心不满足，他请求 Krishna 展示他原初的两臂形体。
So the original form of Krishna is a Shamsundar Krishna, two-arm form, Krishna playing the flute.
所以最原初的两臂形体是 Shamsundar Krishna 的形体。就是吹笛子的那位 Shyamasundar Krishna.
So when Arjuna saw the universal form, he wasn't attracted by it. He offered obeisances to it, And he wanted to see it, but after he saw it, he didn't feel pleasure. And when he saw, when Krishna showed, then Krishna showed him the forearm form, and he also wasn't so attracted to that. And he said to Krishna, he wanted to see his original form, and Krishna took the two-arm form, and Arjuna was happy.
然后，Arjuna又请求去见到 Krishna 的四臂形象。当 Krishna 展示了他的四臂形象， Arjuna 仍然感到不满足，他又想看 Krishna 的原初形体。然后 Krishna 就向他展示了他最原始的两臂的形象。然后，Arjuna这时候呢，Arjuna才感到快乐，开心。
Okay, Shai Gawanti.
SD. 顶拜 Gurudev 和所有奉献者, 请问, Krishna 是 Vaishya, 到11岁就有启迪净化仪式。 一生有几次净化仪式呢? 其他阶层也需要这样的净化仪式吗? 阶段净化吗? So, obeisance to Guru and all devotees, the first question is that Krishna is Vaishya. So at the age of 11, there should be the initiation ceremony, the purification initiation ceremony. So how many purification ceremony are there in one's lifetime?
There are, I think, 10 purification ceremonies.
人的一生应该是有十次净化仪式。
The first one is called the Garbhadhan Samskar, the time the mother and father conceive the child.
第一个净化仪式叫Garbhadhan Samskar，就是父母孕育孩子的这个净化仪式。
And then at the time of the birth of the child, there's another samskar.
婴儿诞生之际呢，就举行另外一次净化，是叫samskar。Then
when the child is 6 months, then we give the first grains to the child.
然后第三个净化仪式是婴儿6个月大的时候，就是第一次进食五谷的时候的。And
then after 1 year or more, then the first haircutting ceremony.
第四个净化仪式是婴儿一岁大的时候。
And then the next ceremony is when the child begins to study for education.
再下一个仪式是孩子开始学习，然后接受教育的仪式。And
then you have the sacred thread ceremony, just like you're hearing.
第六个净化仪式是接受圣献的仪式。And
then you will have the marriage ceremony.
第七个仪式是结婚的仪式。And
then death ceremony.
然后是死亡葬礼。So
like that, these are called samskars, and they're meant for the purification of the soul.
就诸如此类的，这个是为了净化灵魂这些仪式。
Okay. Second question. She had many questions, right?
Yes. So, are there any other purification ceremony for the other castes?
Well, there all these samskars are there.
净化仪式都在那里.
For everyone.
每个人都需要.
At least the higher caste, the Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, they all get the sacred thread. The Sudras, they don't usually get sacred thread.
Brahmana, Poloman, Shabili 和 Vaishya 阶层，他们有圣线，他们需要接受圣线。Sudra, 他不需要。
But we're not following that Vanasha.
然而我们不遵守这个 Vanasha。
So everyone who practices Krishna consciousness, if they're following four principles and chanting regularly, then they can become qualified for the sacred thread.
无论是谁，只要他修习 Krishna 之觉，遵守四项规范原则，念诵，他就有资格获得圣限。
Of course, we're talking about men, we don't talk about, we're not saying women.
在这里呢指的是男子，这里就没有说的是不包括女子。
Different ceremonies for women.
对于女性是不同的仪式。
But they will also get the first grains and the garbhadan and the first grains and the first hair cutting ceremony, and they won't have to go to the Gurukula to get sacred thread though. That's only for the men, the male.
就是对于女性，她们也有孕蛋的净化仪式，还有第一次拾谷物的仪式，以及剪头发的仪式。但是他们不会去咕噜咕了，他们不会去那里去获得圣线，获得圣线就是前面说的呢，都是对于男性的。
Mm-hmm.
So the second part is that the Krishna that is going to Mathura, so what, how many arms are for this Krishna?
Two arms.
两臂 ，Krishna 去 Mathura 是两臂的。
But the Krishna who goes to Mathura is not Shyamsundar Krishna, but he is Vasudev Krishna.
去嘛，但是这位 Krishna 不是 Shyamsundar Krishna, 而是 Vasudeva Krishna.
Shyamsundar Krishna stays in Vrindavan.But Vasudev Krishna, he goes, and it's Vasudev Krishna who kills the demons. Shyamsundar Krishna doesn't kill the demons.
Shyamsundar Krishna, he lives in Vrindavan. He won't kill the demons. Vasudev Krishna went to Mathura. He killed the demons.
So Vasudev Krishna, of course, yeah, it would be a four-arm form, but Vasudev Krishna can assume a two-arm form. He can assume a two-arm form. Although his original form is four arms, he can assume a two-arm form for the purpose of pastime.
虽然最原初的 Vasudev Krishna 是四臂形象，但是呢，他也可以为了上演逍遥时光的缘故呢，展示他的两臂形象。
Just like Krishna on the battlefield at Kurukshetra. Now Krishna on the battlefield at Kurukshetra, that's Vasudev Krishna, that's not Shyamsundar Krishna.
就像在库尔基尔战役当中的 Krishna 是 Vasudev Krishna, 不是 Shyamsundar Krishna.
还有问题吗？
还有一个是亚穆纳熊，今天讲的那个湖是不是到现在还存在着马通人？感谢老师。
Yes, that lake is still there, Akrura Tirtha, or the Brahma Lake is still there. And when you go there, when you come to on the way to between Mathura and Vrindavan, you will see that lake.
是的，那个啊 ，Akrura Tirtha 也就是 Brahma 湖，就在 Mathura 和 Vrindavan 之间的那个路段上，可以看见。
Everyone who goes on the math, if you go on the Vrindavan Parikrama, they will always go there to take a bath there at that Akrura Ghat, the Akrura Tirtha. It's an important holy place. How you went, Ima?
没有了, so Panchatattva Dasa, thank you for your mercy, dear Mara, Hare Krishna.
Thank Panchatattva for his mercy.
感谢 Panchatattva 的仁慈.
Okay, so we will stop here today then. Om Ganshya Guru Mani, Giwa Majantai Defani, Ganshya Sati Mati, Emi Mataji Jujur, Ganshya Sayoda Function, Jer Ling Ting, Wenwenti, Jufu Niman, Chang Song Kwaila, Wanshir Rui, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki,
Jai,
Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki,
Jai,
Hare Krishna.